How'd you get involved in fantasy football?
About 7 years ago, we started. It was starting to, you know, get popular, Drew, and it's just so much fun. All the guys get together, and now girls too. Val Porter's in the league. But it's a ton of fun because you really find yourself watching every game. It's like Thursday night you're watching games. Monday night you're watching games. You know, it's great. You know, it gives you a chance to follow. If you have a player in like Monday night or something like that, you'll watch them. And plus, of course, you pick your favorite Steelers. You can root them on. So, yeah, it's just a great you know, fun thing for football fans, I'll tell you that.
But this gets pretty intense. I mean, how long have you been working to get ready for tonight's draft?
I took 2 weeks off at the end of the season, and then I got back to work. Kind of like a Gruden style. I get up, you know, 3:30 in the morning, start working on it.
Before the morning show.
Do the show, get back, start working on it again. Gets rather intense as we're building up to this draft. I'm pretty much ready.
I see you've got your notes there. I mean,
yes.
What do you have there? What's all the information?
Well, I got all my picks, my sleeper picks, you know, who's going to be on the board here for me. You know, you got to watch. There's a lot of strategy involved, you know, because you never know who's going to take him. You know, in front of you, you only have so much time. I try to follow Kevin Colbert is my idol. So that's the kind of general manager I am. I try to be. As a matter of fact, this year I intend to draft a punter in the fourth round. Even though we don't get any points for it. I don't care.
Let's see. You've won one championship.
Yes, yes. 2003 was a great year. We took it all.
Yeah. You've been in three title games.
Yes.
And last year you missed the playoffs.
It hurt. I feel the heat. I feel the pressure, you know, missing the playoffs last year. But let me stress this to people. This is not a rebuilding year. This is a retooling year for me. So I'm not just scrapping it all. I still got, you know, I still got players. I feel good about this year, Andrew. Feel real good.
I get that sense. Why? How intense does this get? I mean, is it so intense that you end up forgetting about other things in life? This becomes your sole focus?
It's your typical thing. You call each other names, death threats, all that kind of stuff. We go, no. No, we do end up getting into each other. It's so funny how we call each other, you know, agitate each other. You know, we get on each other pretty good. Yeah, so it's very painful when you lose. Very painful. I can't sleep after a lot.
Well, the question I think everybody wants to know, you're picking eighth, right?
I'm picking fourth because that's how bad of a year I had.
Okay, fourth.
Okay,
fourth.
Maybe it is more of a rebuilding year. I'm lying.
Will you take Ben Roethlisberger?
Yes.
Number one overall.
Yes, I will take Ben Roethlisberger, the fourth pick. He's going to open up the offense. This is Ben's year. This is his big year. Tons of points. And I promised him in training camp. So I'm picking you first, buddy.
And what do you say?
He's all right, you know. He's a good guy. I'm a character guy. I go for good characters on my team. It's all about building character with your team. So Ben's the best. He's leading the way for me.
Finally, is this the kind of thing where obviously it's so important that you win that sometimes you actually will not only cheer against the Steelers, your favorite team, but pick players, you know, want Steel players not
right,
to do well, so your player does better.
Right, I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
No, that's where everybody like draws the line. You never can cheer against the Steelers. All bets off. If you have another player against the Steelers, you just got to go for the Steelers. You hope for the win. Like if you have a wide receiver or something for another team, you hope we win like by 30 points, but maybe he'll catch maybe one, you know, touchdown at the end of the game or something like that. But no, you always got to root for the Steelers first. Yeah, that's just the rule.
But wouldn't you say, I mean, there are other leagues where that's not the rule.
I'm sure. In Pittsburgh, though, that's the rule. Steelers first, everything else second. The key is we'll all be battling to pick Steelers on our team, so, you know, don't have to worry about that. Like, there's certain things that I can't do. Mm-hmm. I cannot draft a Cleveland Brown or a Raven. I just can't do it. I don't have it in me.
So, obviously, team loyalty first, then the league second.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Steelers first, league second. Yeah. But it's going to be a huge year for Steelers. You know, so Ben's the obvious choice for me, first pick.
Yeah. Thanks, Jim.
Thanks, Drew. Appreciate it, buddy.